One question I get asked a lot on this channel is how or where do you read the Pokemon Adventures manga? So I've decided to make a video detailing my opinions on the best way to get into the series. Of course, you don't have to follow this, but this is just my opinion and personal guide. Starting off, let's discuss what to read first. In terms of starting points in the series, I think the best three options would be either the first arc, Red, Green and Blue, the seventh arc, Diamond and Pearl, or the tenth arc, Black and White. Personally, these three arcs all feel like a good beginning or introduction to the series, and also some of the strongest arcs the series has produced. The Red, Green and Blue arc covers the adventures of Red and Kanto, and it spans the first 40 chapters of the series. I recommend starting here the most, as it gives you a good introduction to the world of Pokemon Adventures, and how it differs from the games and anime. It follows a simple story that uses the first game as a baseline. However, it doesn't just have Red simply taking on the gyms, instead focusing more on the plot of the villainous Team Rocket. It's also the first arc chronologically, so there's that too. If you chose to start here, I suggest continuing to read the story in order of the game's release date. This is how most people read the series and gives you the chance to come back to old characters when their arcs get remade. For example, the third arc is Gold and Silver, but then many arcs later, you come back to them in Heart Gold and Soul Silver. The Diamond and Pearl arc is 79 chapters long, and although that may seem long at first, that's all because it's a well-paced arc, making sure to give focus on each of the characters and create a lovable cast of heroes and villains. It follows Diamond and Pearl, two wannabe Pokemon comedians, on an accidental quest as Platinum's bodyguards. Whilst on their journey, they have to fight against the evil Team Galactic. This arc gives a bit of everything the Diamond and Pearl games have to offer, like gym battles, contests, and many more. It's also pretty standalone, despite the fact that it's technically the 7th chapter, so you won't be punished if you start here. If you chose to start here, I suggest reading the Platinum arc next, as that serves as a direct sequel to this story. Then, once you're done those two, go into the Black and White section, or back to the Red, Green and Blue section. As from this, you would have gotten a taste of what the series has to offer. If what you look for in a story is characters, then this is the arc for you. And lastly, in terms of starting points, we have the Black and White arc. This arc is 64 chapters and is great in terms of the story, truly bringing out the potential of Generation 5 and the moral standpoint of catching Pokemon. If you're more of a traditional fan of the Pokemon series, then this would be the best choice for you, as it follows Black on his journey to gather all 8 gym badges and win the Pokemon League, as it has been his dream. On his journey, he's joined by a girl called White, who owns her own Pokemon acting agency, as she follows her own dream. As I mentioned, this story is way more traditional than the others, so if this is more your speed, then here you are. If you chose to start here, I recommend you read the Black and White 2 arc next, as if you couldn't guess, it's a direct sequel to this one. But once again, once you're done with these two arcs, I suggest you go back to Diamond and Pearl, or go back to the very beginning. If you're a fan of storytelling and moral standpoints, then this is the arc for you. In terms of starting points, that's everything. But before we get onto where to read, I want to clear up two things in terms of reading order. Although the stories come out in terms of release date, this is not the chronological way to read the stories. I do, however, recommend you read the stories in release dates, but if you're a lover of timeline stuff, the best way to read the story would be chronologically. The chronological order goes as follows. Start at the Red, Green, and Blue arc, then follow the game's release order up until the Emerald arc. Once there, the next arc would be Heart Gold and Soul Silver. After that would be Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire, and then you would go back to Diamond and Pearl and continue in release date order. Once again, I personally don't advise reading the story this way, but some people may prefer to follow the timeline. Okay, so that's the order settled. Let's get into how you can actually read the manga. I speak English, so I'll be covering English translations. The simplest way to get into the series is through the Viz translations of the manga, available to be bought in numerous ways, like standalone volumes, box sets, or the best way, the collector's edition. The collector's edition features big pages, collects 3 volumes in one book, and are overall just higher quality than the standalone versions. If you buy these, then you can read the first 6 arcs in only 10 volumes. After this, however, you would have to buy the rest of the series in their standalone or box set versions, starting from Diamond and Pearl. This is because Viz hasn't released collector's editions of the other books. If they plan to do this in the future, I don't know of yet, so I can only recommend getting the regular versions. If you care about consistency in your collection, remember for when buying these books, you get the ones with Pokemon Adventures on the front, rather than just a game title. The ones with just a game title are mini volumes. This means they're shorter and also there's more of them. Also, if you get the Adventures ones, that means you also won't have to pay as much money. Once you've caught up, however, you will have to be patient, as the translations can take quite a while. And that's pretty much the best way to read the books physically. But what if you want to read the series digitally, as that's what some people prefer? Well, the Viz website has you sorted. I'll link it in the description, and it allows you to purchase all their books in digital format. The Viz versions, however, do come at the cost of censorship in some scenes. So keep that in mind. If you wanted to read the manga uncensored, well, this final section may adhere to you. With any form of media, some sites will just let you see stuff for free. Since I have to remain professional and all that, I can't just link to you any websites exactly, but the Pokemon Adventures Reddit does offer people a section of how to read the manga, with quite a bit of detail, so I'll be sure to link that in the description. This place will give you a pretty simple guide of how to read the manga online, and for free. But of course, don't forget to support the official release. And that's my opinion on how to read the Pokemon Adventures manga series. If you have any more questions, feel free to ask in the comment section down below, or on the Pokemon Adventures Reddit, as that place is really helpful and a great way to get introduced to the community, as well as share your opinions. Now, with all that said and done, I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you all in the next one. Take care.